library's virtual exhibits. Due to the fact that we can't have our in-house exhibits, we've decided to do something a little bit special and have virtual exhibits for now. My name is Mary Ann, and I will be hosting today's virtual exhibit, and filming our video is our own very own Holly Smith. Today we have with us Dennis Yanosky showcasing seascapes in oil. In fact, Dennis is a South Amboy High School alumni. I didn't realize that, which is a great thing. We're going to ask him a few questions on his art, his background, and how he came apart, to do this type of artwork. So, Dennis, tell us a little bit about yourself and how you became involved in actual oil paintings.
Okay. Well, thank you. Thanks for inviting me. I appreciate it. Basically, I was in South Amboy. I live in South Amboy, and I really enjoyed art as I was growing up. When I went to the first art class at South Amboy High School, our art teacher, her name was Mrs. Reese.
Okay.
I really learned a lot from her, and she helped me tremendously in giving me my first oil paints and brushes, and encouraged me to paint.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how I started the painting process in oils. Nowadays, a lot of people do paint in acrylics, but I just stayed with oils throughout the years. And then, thanks to her, I was able to get a grant to Montclair State College at the time.
Wow.
That's a university.
Mm-hmm.
And one of my favorite classes was the painting classes. I guess I got better grades in painting than anything else. My teacher was Mr. Barnett, and his father was Will Barnett, which is a very famous American painter. He just let us do our thing, and he did teach, and he's a great mentor also, Mr. Barnett. So from there, I just went to an art company after college. I graduated with a fine art degree.
Okay.
I went to a company in New Jersey, and I was an artist at the company. But I didn't care for doing the corporate type of work.
Okay, all right, you know? Yes.
I just like to paint on my own freestyle, and especially the ocean. Okay. I grew up in South Amboy, and would surf the Jersey coast. So in my paintings, I try to feel the ocean, the waves, so what I wanted to do with my houses and the places I live is have ocean paintings in my houses. And so when I painted, I wanted to make a painting that I want, you know.
Yes.
Not necessarily what other people want. So any painting I have here is something that I wanted to hang in my house. So that's basically how I got to the point of doing seascapes, because I felt seascapes were one of the greatest challenges to an oil painting.
Okay. That being said, can you give us a little bit of background on these paintings, these seascape paintings that we have here for display? I mean, they're all gorgeous. I mean, I know a lot of people state that they like the ocean and everything because it has that calming effect,
yeah.
Right? But then also, too, Mother Nature can have it really pounding down at you.
Yes, yes.
So if you could give us a little bit of a brief outline on these seascapes.
Okay, well, as you said, the calming effect isn't really evident here. but I wanted to show emotion, and I wanted to feel, and now that I do exhibit, so I want other people to feel the motion of the waves also, and the motion of the ocean. So, for instance, this is called Before Sandy. These are all from Wall Branch right here.
Oh, okay.
So this is Before Sandy. Hurricane Sandy came in at Wall Branch. I went down, and the waves were, crashing in. I guess there was a day and a half to 2 days before Sandy was going to mm-hmm. hit the Jersey coast. So this depicted that time, and then this one right here, this is called After Sandy. And that's about a week after Sandy, or maybe 4 days after Sandy. It was really violent. You could see the violence in the waves coming in. And that got into one of the artist magazines, National Artist Magazines.
Wow. That's great.
And then we have this one here. This is, this was Long Branch also, but at that day, the waves were forming in an abnormal manner, you know, and the lights were shining through as the waves came over the top. You'll see this one right here. You'll see light filtered through the wave as it's breaking.
Yes, yes.
I try to depict that in the picture too. And this one is called, backwash, backswell actually. Mm-hmm. And that happens when there's like a heavy wash of water going back out into the ocean, but also a heavy wave coming in, normally at like a high tide, and they both hit each other and they come up and cause a little spray right there where you see the spray.
Yes.
Right here.
Very nice, yeah.
And so, and this one is called Incoming. And I just wanted to depict the light coming through. It's actually based on another painting that I made. My wife is a twin. And I saw these waves coming in at twins.
Okay.
And I said, you know what?
Good comparison.
I'm going to paint a painting for my wife and call it New Jersey Twins. You know?
Very nice.
And that actually got into another national magazine. But that's why I painted the two waves coming through like this, and the twins are coming in.
All right, now, did you do a picture for your wife and her twin?
No.
Oh, you should have. That would have been a good holiday present.
I want to think of it. Well, maybe now I have to give it to her.
Yeah, right. Now, Dennis, I know that doing seascapes in oils is pretty difficult. Can you elaborate on that a little bit more, because you know, for somebody like me or our audience out there, you know, might not be too familiar with the different types of painting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, for instance, when you go to art school, they'll teach you in the fine arts, they'll teach you, like a still life painting. So you put an apple there with a piece of fruit or something.
Yeah.
Piece of fruit. And a flower, and you paint that, you can come back anytime you want to paint it. But if you're out there taking sketches of the sea, you know, it changes. It changes and it varies with the lighting, it changes with the time of day. If it's in the morning, you might have more fog, less of a burn off. For instance, the one behind you that was like fine noon.
Okay.
And you see the filtering of the light is different. So what happens is that now I want to capture the motion, and to try to capture motion in painting is kind of difficult because you have to know the contours of the waves of the flat water that's coming in.
Mm-hmm.
You'll see the foam patterns, and that actually develops into patterns where you could capture motion also. And then when the waves are breaking over, you want to capture that and then make it look like it's motion. So these things are, you know, it takes time to develop. And when I first started, you know, it's frustrating. But then also you have to know what type of paints to use. You have to use a lot of translucent paints and transparent paints and not opaque paints. Opaque meaning white paint.
Okay, are like these types of paints you have here, that's what you're talking about?
Yeah, I don't want to give away too many secrets.
Oh, no, I understand that. But plus too, when I had asked you about, how do you, if oil painting seascapes is very difficult. Now you say you actually go out and you're actually sketching first.
I make sketches.
Do you take like photographs?
Yeah, I'll take reference photographs. And sometimes I'll just take the photograph and manipulate the photograph. And sometimes I'll make a composite of various photographs and put it together.
That's
obviously
interesting.
That is not, you know, right there, but this, I changed some of the rocks. I took a rock out here and there just to make the composition a little better.
That's your the artist view of what he wants to see, right?
Yeah.
Oh wow, okay. Now, I know that you had mentioned on some of your paintings that you had won awards. How many awards have you won so far for your artwork?
Well, it was accepted into some national magazines.
Wow.
And the Artist Magazine, Southwestern Art, and a few here and there.
You'd be proud of yourself. I mean, that's an accomplishment.
But mostly what I like to do is exhibit and sell. I'll sell at art fairs. Morristown has a really great art fair every June. And they bring artists in from all over the East Coast, from Florida to Maine. And I'll have about 60 artists put up tents, and they'll sell them at the Vail Mansion right near the Green in Morristown. And such a fair such as that, and exhibit in the galleries, various galleries, Morristown, wherever.
Dennis, I know in the beginning when you were talking about your background and how you got involved in the arts, you were in high school, and then at times you had stated that you were a little bit frustrated with that, but you had such great teachers. What kind of advice would you give someone that wants to get started in the arts? And like, it doesn't have to be like a boy or a girl, a young child, you know, but somebody like my age might want to get interested. What would you say to them? Where should they start out to direct their talent?
Anybody can start at any time. People could be small, you know, children, little children, adults, 90 years old, they could start in the arts. And you could start in any medium. Pick a medium that you're comfortable in and subjects that you're comfortable in. You could do seascapes, you could do portraits, you could do still lifes.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, I taught fourth graders in a private school in Morristown, and my goal was to allow them to bring home a painting so that they could hang, and then when they're 20 years later, they could look at it and say, wow, I did that.
Yeah.
So I gave them this subject to do in an 11 by 14 format. And I went through the process and the steps to do this. So anybody could do any of these paintings with these steps that I showed the fourth graders in oils. And so if the fourth graders could do it and they did a great job, I think anybody could do it.
That's fabulous. Where can people view your artwork and purchase it? I know, I think you said that you have a Facebook page set up for that.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's www.facebook.com/Dennis Joseph Minoski Paintings. And then if you go to that, there's a link also for a Square store. You can go to that store, but all my paintings are basically at the Facebook page.
Okay.
Facebook.com. Even if you go to Facebook.com and you do a search for Dennis Joseph Minoski, my site will come up.
Oh, perfect. That makes it a lot easier.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to end the interview part of this video. Thank you again, Dennis, for sharing your talent with us and our patrons. We all hope everyone enjoyed today's virtual exhibit and look forward to seeing your exhibit physically in the library in the very near future. Don't forget, patrons, stay tuned for part two of this video. We have a special treat. Dennis has graciously decided to demonstrate the process from starting to end of doing an actual canvas. So don't forget to check out part two after this interview on YouTube.